Hey guys, it's Robin, and welcome to the Science of Self-Care. Today I want to talk a little bit about walking and why it is an underrated form of physical activity. So there's two really lovely things about walking. The first is that it's a low stress form of physical activity, and the second is that it's easy to pair with other forms of activity because it is so low intensity. So often exercise intensity is measured in terms of the percentage of VO2 max that it requires. Our VO2 max is the maximum amount of oxygen we can use when we are fully exerting ourselves in very intense activity. This is different for everyone depending on your condition, your age, and walking usually falls around the 40th percentile. So that means you're using a little less than half of the maximum amount of oxygen you would use if you were fully exerting yourself. And what's really interesting is that several studies have identified a sort of threshold at around the 50th to 60th percentile at which physical activity starts to release cortisol in the body and induce a type of stress response. This is not necessarily a bad thing because stressing our body in the right way can actually help us build our condition and help us build muscle. However, it does mean that we should be mindful of when we are doing these sorts of activities. And the great thing about walking is that it actually falls right below that threshold. There's even one study that actually showed that activities around the 40% VO2 max level can actually work to decrease cortisol levels. So walking is different than most types of physical activity because it is not inducing a stress response on the body and is something that everyone can practice every single day without overtraining or doing any harm to their body. So another beautiful thing about walking is that because it is so low intensity, it's very easy to accompany your walk with other types of activities. For example, artistic activities like photography or listening to music or singing. It's easy to combine with socializing, with friends, talking, laughing, and it is also very easy to be fully present during walking, so it's great for learning, absorbing audiobooks, podcasts, and that is actually very useful because often the types of physical activity we continue to do in the long run over years and decades are activities that are tied to things other than our physical health. In the book No Sweat by Michelle Seeger, she touches upon the fact that the most consistent way to keep up exercise is to realize what you would like to get from your exercise to motivate you, whether that's socializing or reflection time, time in nature, creative time. There are so many other ways in which physical activity can actually give back to our body and mind. And when we attach more positive benefits to our physical activity of choice, then we will continue to want to do it for many years to come. And walking is perfect for coupling to all sorts of activities we can start to practice today and continue to practice for the rest of our life and really learn to love. I had the good fortune of starting this new year in New York City, and I was able to kick off 2020 walking all around Manhattan. Without thought, I was able to walk 27,000 steps that day. It's just so effortless and it's so easy on the body, and you can easily walk miles and miles and not get fatigued in the same way that you do when you go running, and it's something I look forward to. So I invite you to try adding a few more thousand steps to your day. If you're currently walking around 8,000 steps, try to hit 10,000 if you're walking 10,000, go for 12,000. Adding a few more thousand steps in a day is a challenge that is approachable for everyone, and I think will bring many people lots of peace of mind and calm in the new year. So I wish you a beautiful 2020. I'm looking forward to making more concise videos more frequently this year. If you have any comments on any videos or suggestions, I would love to hear it. I'm just gonna keep creating and hope you guys enjoy. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.